The main contributing factors for a miscarriage of justice are eyewitness misidentification, faulty forensic analysis, false confessions by vulnerable suspects, perjury and lies stated by witnesses, misconduct by police, prosecutors or judges, and or ineffective assistance of counsel, inadequate defense strategies by the defendant's or respondent's legal team. Wrongful convictions can occur when items which become evidence at crime scenes become contaminated in the process of packaging, collection and transportation to a secured facility or laboratory. Contamination can be introduced unintentionally by material that was not present when the crime was committed by anyone entering the crime scene after the event, by uninvolved witnesses who may become suspects, and by emergency responders, firefighters, police officers and crime scene investigators themselves. If proper protocols are not followed, evidence can also be contaminated when it is being analyzed or stored. A miscarriage of justice can occur when procedures to prevent contamination are not carried out carefully and accurately. The case of Hugh Gilt was a true example of miscarriage of justice due to misconduct by police. Hugh Gilt was an Inner Mongolian. He was born in 1977, in China. Hugh Gilt was accused of raping a woman surnamed Yang. She was raped and murdered inside a public toilet in a Hohhot textile factory on the 9th of April 1996. The woman had been fatally strangled. Hugh Gilt had discovered the body and alerted authorities, but he was arrested and accused of committing the crime. The original trial operated on the grounds that Hugh Gilt had confessed to the crime. The confession occurred within 48 hours. Hohhot authorities stated that there was a quota of criminal cases to conclude, and that this influenced the treatment of Hugh Gilt. In an opinion article about the case, the China Daily stated it has not been rare for higher authorities to exert pressure on local public security departments and judiciary to crack serious murder cases. Nor has it been rare for the police to extort confessions through torture. And suspects have been sentenced without solid evidence except for extorted confessions. Hugh Gilt was held for 61 days. He was 18 at the time of his conviction. He was sentenced to death on the 23rd of May 1996. He was executed by firing squad on the 10th of June 1996. He was 18 at the time of his death. 10 years after the execution of Hugh Gilt, Zhao Zhihong wrote a petition admitting he had committed the crime. Zhao Zhihong, nicknamed the Smiling Killer and Demon, was a Chinese serial killer and rapist. He admitted to committing a total of 20 serious crimes between 1996 and 2005, including raping and killing at least 6 women in Ulankab and Hohhot in Inner Mongolia. Zhao Zhihong was born on the 5th of September 1972 in the village of Yongxing, Langcheng County. After graduating from school, he worked in low-skill jobs without staying anywhere for a long time. Zhao committed his first murder on the 9th of April 1996, raping and strangling a young textile mill worker surnamed Yang in a public toilet in Hohhot. Her body was discovered by an 18-year-old Chinese Mongol named Hugh Gilt, who was mistakenly accused of the murder, forced to confess by investigators, and sentenced to death on the 23rd of May 1996. He was executed by firing squad on the 10th of June 1996. On the 20th of May 2000, Zhao committed a second rape murder of a young girl in the Hohhot area, which remained unsolved for a long time. He did not kill again until 2005, when he raped and killed four girls and women. The first two occurred on 2 and the 7th of January, and the third on the 24th of February. At the same time, local authorities were seriously worried about the serial killings, offering a reward of 2,000 yuan for information about the killer's identity and whereabouts. In July 2005, Zhao killed his last victim. In June 2005, a resident of the village of Tali by name of Yun Wen, in suburban Hohhot, where Zhao committed his last killings, identified the killer from a photo shoot. However, she did not know his name or place of residence. While looking for the offender with the police, she identified Zhao Zhihong at his workplace, and on the 23rd of October 2005, he was arrested. Zhao immediately confessed, admitting to having committed more than 20 crimes between 1996 and 2005, including 6 murders and 10 rapes, 2 of which were against minors. In addition, he was also responsible for several cases of robberies, theft and misappropriation of property. Most controversially, he admitted to killing the mill worker Yang in 1996, a crime for which the 18-year-old Hu Jilt was executed. Due to the constantly opening up of new circumstances of Zhao's crimes, the trial of the killer was adjourned all the time. At the same time, on the 15th of December 2014, the Hohhot District Court posthumously acquitted Hu Jilt, publicly apologizing to his relatives and paying them 330,000 yuan in compensation. Zhao's trial began on the 5th of January 2015 and was held behind closed doors. In total, the serial killer was charged with 21 crimes. Zhao himself expressed regret that an innocent man was executed for his crime, and apologized in his courtroom confession. Nevertheless, on the 9th of February 2015, the District Court of Hohhot found the 42-year-old guilty of 6 murders, 10 rapes and at least one case of robbery. He was sentenced to death by firing squad. In addition, according to the court's verdict, he was obliged to pay a fine of 155,000 yuan, of which 53,000 to the state and 102,000 to the victim's relatives. On the 30th of July 2019, Zhao was executed. Before his execution, he refused a last meeting with the victim's relatives, which was due to him by law. After Zhao's confession, Hu Jilt's parents demanded that the court system revisit the murder case so Hu Jilt may be exonerated. The retrial of Hu Jilt in the High People's Court of Inner Mongolia Autonomous Region took place from November through December 2014, concluding with his exoneration. It was partially on the grounds that in his confession he did not properly recount the crime, nor the physical description and accent of Yang. The deputy president of the court, Zhao Jianping, gave 30,000 renminbi, which was $4,500 to Hu Jilt's parents, Li Sanren and Shang Ayun. Both Li and Shang received 2 million renminbi, which is equivalent to $332,116, in compensation from the Higher People's Court of Inner Mongolia, making up for the length of Hu Jilt's detention. His death, the loss experienced by Li and Chang, and the costs of the funeral. Hugh Jilt's family took a copy of the exoneration notice to his gravesite and burned it there as a way of telling him that he had been exonerated. Inner Mongolia authorities sanctioned 27 government officials as a result of the wrongful execution. Thank you for watching Death Row.